Hi, welcome to Power Brains, the digital workshops. It's a pioneer workshop in memory improvement. I am Kailash. I am from Anand Foundation. We believe that every person in the world, they are having a lot of power, a lot of potential, a lot of energy. But most of the people, they are not aware how to use that power. Once you make them aware of their power, they are going to create wonders in their life. Especially students, nowadays students, they are having a lot of unlimited intelligence. Unfortunate, that is getting perverted in some different ways. That's why to help the students, we have prepared this powerful workshop. This is the first of its kind in India. By the end of the program, we promise that you are going to get wonderful results, so that you will come to know how you can utilize your brain power fully.
Okay.
First, let me congratulate for taking first step towards improving yourself. Are you interested in improving yourself?
I am.
Yes. Like this, most of the students interested in improving yourself.
You tell me why you are preparing this digital workshop.
Okay. Why we are preparing digital workshops is, actually, as a trainer and on some of my friends' trainers, we have been conducting workshops in different parts of the country. Mm-hmm. What happened? This type of workshops are available only for the people who are residing in cities. Whereas the B-grade towns and middle class towns and villages, these types of workshops, they are not at all aware.
Right.
That's why to help the people from small towns and small villages, this program we have created.
Mm-hmm.
Hope it's going to be helpful for a lot of students. Let us start the journey.
Yes.
Yeah. When you get into flight, air hostess may come and she may greet you and she may start giving some instructions or guidelines. Why they give the instructions?
For safety measures.
For safety. Yes. To have safe journey. Same the way, now we are going to share some of the guidelines for our safe journey of Power Brains. Because now journey we are going to start. The journey may take 7 days. You may be wondering, 7 days journey? Don't worry, I will help you how you can have pleasant journey. First instruction, please watch the program very carefully. This is not any entertainment program. Of course, we are made in an entertainment way, and it is about learning yourself. Don't watch this program just to know the things.
Okay.
Whenever you are watching, start learning and applying that learning immediately. As soon as the program started, whatever the instructions we have been giving, just to keep on following the instructions as it is. Yes, I will be giving instruction to Shruta. She will be doing. So what you can do is, whatever she is doing, you can also start applying. So this is first.
Okay, Kailash, tell me, what's the next step?
Okay, next is, please don't complete entire this digital workshop in one day.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, it may take around 7 to 8 hours, but don't complete.
Okay.
The reason is, our mind is having so much interested to know the things,
yes,
rather than application. First, we want to see everything. Please don't do this one. If you see, you may not get 100% benefit. What you can do is, just spare some time. Third instruction is, spare daily at least 1 hour.
Okay, daily 1 hour.
Daily 1 hour.
Mm-hmm.
Suppose you cannot spare daily 1 hour, at least alternate days 1 hour.
1 hour.
So don't watch entire program in a day.
And
right?
You have to apply that also, not only
watching. Yes, yes. Not
right.
Only watching. You have to start applying that techniques into your regular life.
Okay.
So now the fourth point is, please maintain a routine. Anything if you want to learn, you should have some routine. Then you can learn better. Any skill, if you want to become master of the skill, there should be routine.
Routine should
be. Like you might have seen Sachin Tendulkar, whenever he goes daily, he will be going for net practice.
Yes.
Right?
Net practice is very
important. So routine is important. What you can do is daily fix one particular time. Suppose if you want to watch this one evening, daily start watching in evening. Suppose if you want to start in morning, you can start watching in the morning and fix some schedule.
Particular time.
Okay. And particular day also, like once every day you can watch, or once in a 2 days. Okay? Routine. Next, fifth is, the workshop has been divided into modules.
Okay.
What you can do is, please go through first module.
Okay.
Understand. And start applying. Suppose if you are unable to understand module, once again go back and watch carefully. Once you understand the module, then only go to second module.
Okay, before understanding, don't go further.
Yes. Because the program has been designed in a building block method.
Okay.
Like, if you are not learning alphabets, like A, B, C, D, can you write the words?
No.
Right, suppose if you are not learning the words, can you write the sentences?
No.
Suppose if you don't know how to write the sentences, can you write the paragraph?
No.
No. Same the way this workshop has been designed in a building block. So what you can do is, just complete one module, then go to next module. Right? Now this is fifth point. Next, sixth point is, in the workshop, you have to do some activities. Be active. Don't be passive. Passive means just listening. Active means you will be participating.
By doing it.
Yes. In my workshop, what happened? Our people and our volunteers will be making the students to participate. Here, you have to take your own initiation.
Right.
Okay, be participant. Like whenever you are watching with your friends also, be active. Whatever the activities we are saying, we are showing on the screen, start doing then and there itself. Don't postpone the activities. Okay? Very important. Next, very much important is, please switch off the mobile phone. Seventh point is, switch off the mobile phone. Because nowadays, lot of distraction is happening with the mobile phone.
Because of mobile phones,
SMS may be coming, phone will be ringing. Better is switch off your mobile phone. Take control of your time. Same time, please switch off television, switch off the radio, or any electronic gadgets or music instruments. Please switch off. See that you are sitting at least somewhat silent place. So, seventh point. Now the eighth point is, at present you may be standing. What you can do is sit in a comfortable chair.
Okay.
Now when I am saying sit in a comfortable chair, see that you are sitting straight. Okay. So that you should be able to watch comfortably. Don't create stress in your body. Next is, please don't sit in sofas and start watching. Don't sit on the bed. Preferably take one chair, sit comfortably. Next is, ninth point, see that you are not getting disturbed with any person.
Okay.
Best thing is, before start watching this one, you can inform to your family. But
how it's possible, Kailash? Usually people come and ask something, they keep on disturbing us.
Best thing is, your parents are the best friends. Take the help of your parents. Tell them, this is a powerful program, I want to watch, because they are given the instruction to like this, and give the responsibility for them. See that if any friends are coming, they will engage them. If any mobile comes, any phone call comes, they will engage and they will not disturb you. Right? So best is, you can close the door and sit inside the room and start watching. The reason is, in between if somebody comes and disturbance, you lose the concentration. So best focus on this one. Next, keep the following items ready with you.
Which are those?
They are, keep one pen ready with you, pencil, some white sheets, one rough notebook, sketch pens, color pencils or crayons, and you can keep one water bottle with you.
Water bottle, sir?
Yeah. Why I am saying is, when you are watching, suppose if you feel thirsty, just you can pause and you can have the water. Why I am saying is, suppose if you are not keeping water bottle, what happen? When you are watching, if you feel thirsty, you want to go to kitchen. When you are going kitchen, you will be meeting your brother, sister, and in the kitchen some items will come. You will get distracted. Around 15-20 minutes time will go. Once again, once you come back, you may lose the concentration.
That's right.
So you may not, once again you have to start from beginning. Mm. Don't do it. So take water bottle and keep ready with you. Right?
Okay, so I can take water bottle. Can I take some eatable also?
No, don't do that mistake. Please don't eat when you are watching. This is my 11th point. Don't eat anything when you are watching. Not only watching, my friends, whenever you are studying and learning anything, don't eat. The reason is, when you are eating, a lot of energy goes to digest that food. The main function of the brain is to digest the food. As soon as any food entered into your stomach, brain will go and focus on it, how it can digest. So what will happen? That's why you will not have concentration in studies. You may feeling sleepiness.
That's true.
So that's why don't eat. What you can do is, before starting of the program, half an hour or 1 hour before you can have the food, then you can start watching. Okay? Next. 12th point is, when you are watching, just watch, observe and pay 100% attention on this program. When you are watching this one, don't watch any outside things like a posters or side by side watching movie, some watching SMSs and all. No, you will be doing only one job. That means you will be watching, learning and applying. Clear? So next, the 13th point is, as soon as we are asking the questions, start giving the answers.
Okay.
Suppose in the program, I will be asking some questions. Immediately you have to give me the answer.
Okay.
For example, I will ask you, what is your father's name? You have to give me the answer.
Yes.
Alright. Suppose I will say, what is the first alphabet in English? What is the first alphabet in English?
A.
Like that, you have to give me the answer first. Don't think it is meant for Shruta, it is for you. Right? Like this, you have to give the answers. And next is, very important, when you are watching, don't fold your hands like this. Don't fold. Don't fold your hands. The reason is, whenever you listen anything with your folded hands, even though you are listening, unconsciously you are blocking the information. So that will not go into your mind. So don't fold your hands. Next is, don't be spectator of this program. Okay, don't be spectator. Be a participant. Actively participate. And in this regard, I want to say one more thing. When you are watching or when you are learning this one, if somebody is standing like a spectator, tell them don't stand.
Okay.
Reason is, you are participating, you are involving, some crazy things will be there in the workshop. I may be saying do some crazy things. When you are doing, when some person is standing, for him or her, it may look like a crazy things.
Right.
Then there are chances that they may discourage you. Then you may lose the interest. So please see that if anybody wants to watch, tell them clearly. Let them watch for until the end of the program. Entire program, let them watch. And let them be also a participant. Don't be like a spectator. Next is, the 16th point is, don't force anybody to watch this one.
Okay.
The reason is,
be liberal.
If you got the benefit, you share them. Tell them it's a good program, I got wonderful benefits. Don't force them. That's what old saying goes. You can take horse to the water, but you can't force the horse to drink the water.
Right.
Can you force the horse to drink the water?
No,
just you can take up to the water. So don't force anybody. What you can do is, suppose if you want to help anybody, first you learn.
Okay.
Apply the techniques. Start giving the demonstration in front of all other people. By seeing your demonstration, definitely they will be interested and they will come and start watching. Really, if you want help like this. Next, 19th point, be participant. Once again, we are requesting, be participant. Whatever the instructions are appearing, start applying. And finally, the last but not the least is, be aware. Be 100% aware. What is happening on the screen?
What are you doing?
What you are listening? What thought process is going on? What you are supposed to do? Just follow it. Really wonderful results are going to happen. Wish you all the best. Let us start the journey. Can you start?
Yes.
Start. Come on, let's start the journey. Hi, welcome to Power Brains. Now you are going to learn one powerful technique. This technique is so powerful, which is going to be like a foundation for entire this program. My request is, please follow the instructions, whatever the instructions we are giving. Please pay 100% attention in this program. And one more request, don't go to next module until you complete this session. To make you understand better, Shruta, she is going to help you. Whatever she is doing, just follow it. Are you ready, Shruta?
Yes.
Right? Right. Now I am going to share one wonderful thing. Listen carefully. Whatever I am saying, see everything in pictures.
Okay.
As if you are watching one graphic movie.
Okay, I should see that, I should imagine that.
Yes, that means you have to visualize everything in pictures, as if my friends, you also start doing. And before that, you have to follow some guidelines. The guidelines are, to do this exercise, first you have to sit straight. Okay, sit straight.
Okay.
Keep legs flat on the ground.
Mm-hmm.
And one more instruction is, please don't sit on sofas, don't sit on the bed, and don't sit in the place where people are, there are chances that people may be disturbing.
Yes.
Suppose if TV is running, please switch off the television and switch off the mobile phone. Pay 100% attention. Now let us start. Let me repeat once again. Now I am going to share one wonderful thing. Listen carefully. Whatever I am saying, see everything in pictures.
Yes.
As if you are watching one graphic movie. So to understand better, what you can do is, just you can close your eyes, visualize. So just listen to my words. When you close your eyes, you can see better, right? All right, start. Let us start. Close your eyes.
Okay.
Start visualizing. Imagine you are climbing huge mountain. See that. What you are climbing, tell me.
Huge mountain.
Good. See that on top of the mountain, there is a big blackboard. Very, very big blackboard. See that. On back side of blackboard, visualize one marriage party is going on. See that, what's going on?
Marriage
party. See that in the marriage party, lot of people they came. In between, one crazy doctor has come. See the doctor. He is looking so crazy. Then he started checking everybody. By looking at the crazy doctor, one cute little girl, she get afraid. Who get afraid? Good. See that she got afraid. Immediately she took one big cycle, very big bicycle. She started coming down. See that when she was coming down, on the way there was a big India map, very, very big India map. She has gone and she hit with the India map. After hitting India map, she entered into one big stadium. Now where she has entered, tell me?
One big stadium.
See that very, very big stadium, such a big stadium. In the stadium, she found that one white elephant is moving towards to her. See the white elephant. Which animal is there?
White elephant.
Yeah, white elephant moving towards to her. And white elephant carrying a huge mobile phone. See that very, very big mobile phone. Such a big mobile phone. What the elephant is carrying?
Big mobile phone.
Yeah. She picked up that mobile phone and she started dialing. She called all your teachers. See that all your teachers are coming. All the teachers, they are wearing a joker dress. Which dress they are wearing?
Joker dress.
Ah, they are looking like a jokers now. See that. And they are carrying big blue flowers in their hands. See that. On the flowers, now she started doing exercise. What she is doing now?
Exercise.
Yeah, she is doing exercise. When she was doing exercise, one wonderful thing has happened. Lot of money started falling from sky. See that lot of money is falling from sky. What is falling from sky?
Lot of money.
She felt very, very happy. She picked up all the money and started keeping in a huge lunch box. See that very, very big lunch box. Such a big.
almost 50 feet height lunch box. See that such a huge lunch box. When she started looking at, her brain started expanding. See that her brain is becoming big, big, so big.
Yes.
See that from the brain, one Airtel tower is coming out.
Wow.
See that Airtel tower. On top of Airtel tower, Mahatma Gandhi is jumping. You know Mahatma Gandhi?
Yes.
Who is jumping?
Mahatma Gandhi.
Yeah. Mahatma Gandhi is jumping. Immediately has entered into one big AC office. See that very, very big AC office.
Yes.
See that in the AC office in the corner, there is a huge television. Very big television.
Yes.
See that almost 100 feet length and width. Such a big television. She started watching the television. He started watching. Mahatma Gandhi started watching the television. When he is watching the television, one wonderful thing has happened. See that from the television, Amitabh Bachchan has jumped out. Who has jumped out?
Amitabh Bachchan
has jumped out. Immediately he took one small car. He started driving the car. See that small car. When he is driving the car, one wonderful thing has happened. In the car, there was a big book. Very, very big book. He started reading the book. What is he reading now?
Very big book.
Good. Keep your eyes closed. I'm going to repeat once again. Listen carefully. Okay. Imagine you are climbing huge mountain. My dear friends, once again, you start visualizing everything in pictures. Okay. Like a graphic movie. I am repeating once again. Imagine you are climbing huge mountain. On top of the mountain, there is a big blackboard. On backside of blackboard, one marriage party is going on. See that in the marriage party, one crazy doctor has come. By looking at doctor, one cute little girl, she get afraid. Immediately, she took one big bicycle and she started coming down. When she was coming down, on the way there was a big India map. She hit with the India map. Immediately, she fell down in a huge stadium. Such a big stadium. See that in the stadium, there is one animal, that is white elephant, is moving towards her. The white elephant was carrying big mobile phone. See that very, very big mobile phone. She picked up that mobile phone and she started dialing. She called all your teachers. Teachers wearing a joker dress and carrying blue color flowers in their hands. On the flowers, she started doing exercise. When she is doing exercise, one wonderful thing has happened. A lot of money started falling from sky. She felt very, very happy. She picked up all the money and started keeping in a huge lunch box. By seeing such a huge lunch box, her brain started expanding. See that. From the brain, one Airtel tower is coming out. On top of Airtel tower, Mahatma Gandhi is jumping. Immediately has entered into one AC office. In the AC office, in the corner, there is a huge television. See that. From the television, Amitabh Bachchan has jumped out. Immediately, he took one small car, he started driving the car. When he is driving the car, in the car there was a big book, very big book. He started reading the book. Yes. Now I am going to ask some questions.
Okay.
Give me the answers. Okay? Whatever you understand by seeing the mental pictures. First, what you are climbing?
Mountain.
Good. Mountain. On top of mountain, what is there?
Blackboard.
Good. On backside of blackboard, what's going on?
On marriage party.
Okay. In marriage party, who has come?
Crazy doctor.
Crazy doctor. By looking at doctor, who get afraid?
One small little girl.
Good. Small little girl. What she took?
Bicycle.
Good. With the bicycle, where she dash with?
Indian map.
Okay. Indian map. After hitting Indian map, where she has entered now?
One big stadium.
Good. In the stadium, which animal is there?
White elephant.
White elephant. Okay. White elephant carrying what instrument?
Huge mobile phone.
Okay. With the mobile, whom did she call?
All of her teachers.
Okay. Teachers wearing which dress?
Joker dress.
Good. What they are carrying in their hands?
Blue flowers.
Okay. Blue flowers. On the flowers, what she started doing?
Exercise.
Okay. When she is doing exercise, what started falling from sky?
Money.
Good. All the money. Where she is keeping now?
Huge lunch box.
Huge lunch box. By seeing such a huge lunch box, What started expanding?
Her brain.
Her brain, good. From the brain, what is coming out?
Airtel Tower.
Okay, Airtel Tower. On top of Airtel Tower, who is jumping?
Mahatma Gandhi.
Where he has entered now?
On big AC office.
AC office, see that. In the AC office, what he started watching?
One big television.
Good. From the television, who has jumped out?
Amitabh Bachchan.
What he started driving?
One small car.
Okay, when he is driving car, what he started reading?
One big book.
Good. Keep your eyes closed. This time I am going to say the words. Just check it out whether I am saying correct or not. Okay, you have to say yes or no. Okay. Just see the pictures in your mind picture.
Yes.
Only words I will be saying.
Yes.
See that mountain.
Yes.
Blackboard.
Yes.
Marriage party.
Yes.
Crazy doctor.
Yes.
Girl.
Yes.
Bicycle.
Yes.
India map.
Yes.
Stadium.
Yes.
White elephant.
Yes.
Mobile phone. Teachers,
yes.
Joker dress,
yes.
Blue flowers,
yes.
Exercise,
yes.
Money,
yes.
Lunch box,
yes.
Brain,
mm-hmm.
Airtel Tower,
mm-hmm.
Mahatma Gandhi,
yes.
AC office,
mm-hmm.
Television,
okay.
Amitabh Bachchan,
yes.
Car,
yes.
Book.
Okay.
All are correct?
Yes.
Okay.
Correct.
Now what you can do, you can start saying from mountain.
Okay.
When I say next, you have to say the word. Start from mountain. Start.
Mountain.
Good.
Blackboard.
Good.
Marriage party.
Good.
Crazy doctor.
Good.
Little cute girl.
Good.
Bicycle.
Good.
Indian man.
Good.
Stadium.
Good.
White elephant.
Good.
Cell phone.
Good.
Teachers.
Good.
Joker dress.
Good.
Blue flowers.
Good.
Exercise.
Good.
Money.
Good.
Huge lunchbox.
Good.
Airtel Tower.
Good.
Mahatma Gandhi.
Good.
Big AC office.
Good.
Television.
Good.
Amitabh Bachchan.
Good.
Small car.
Good.
One big book.
Fantastic. My dear friends, same the way, what you can do is open your eyes and in your mind start checking out whether you will be able to say all the words or not. To cross-check what you can do is, you can refer our workbook. In the workbook, all the words have been given. If you want, you can pause the program for some time. Take rest of few minutes. Close your eyes and check it out whether you will be able to say all the words, right from mountain to blackboard, birthday party, up to car and book. So if you want, you can take the break. We'll meet after the break.
It's so amazing, you know. My memory power was so weak, but I can remember everything. It's really wonderful.
Oh, good. Actually, it's what you are seeing is only tip of the iceberg. It is only beginning of the program. If you follow as it is, whatever I'm giving the instructions,
yes.
Every student, the studies will become so easy. And even when I was in college, I was not aware of these techniques. That's why I was feeling like studies were difficult.
Yes.
This is only beginning. First, what you do is, after the break, we'll be learning how you are able to remember all this one.
Mm-hmm.
With this technique and some other techniques, we'll come to know, by the end of the program, you'll come to know how you can remember entire textbook very easily. Wow, look at the screen. So many words, right from mountain, blackboard to last, car and book. All the objects you are able to remember?
Yes, that's what I don't understand. It's so amazing. Within such a short period, I can remember all these things. How is possible?
It's very simple, Shruta. It's very simple, my friends. This method is called linking method. In this, what we are doing is, we are linking one object with another object. Just we are keep on linking. See that mountain to blackboard, blackboard to birthday party. We'll keep on linking. Always remember, brain always links one information with existing information. Anything, if you want to remember any new information, and whenever you are feeding, it will go and connect with existing information, whatever it is already feed in your brain. It's quite natural.
Mm-hmm.
For example, anything if you want to remember, new thing means it may get confused.
Yes.
If any available thing is, it will connect.
Yes.
For example, do you know the meaning of electroencephalograph?
No, I don't know the meaning of that. What
okay.
is it?
Electroencephalograph. I will make you in an easy way. Suppose if I tell you the meaning, you may not be able to remember. I will give in a such a way.
Okay.
For example, you may be knowing ECG, electrocardiograph.
Yes.
You know?
Yes.
Electrocardiograph means, electro means something related with electronics.
Mm-hmm.
Graph means the results representing on sheet of paper, horizontal axis and vertical axis. Cardio means which is related to heart.
Okay.
See the word cardio, it has come from the root called cur. Cur means courage. Cardiology,
mm-hmm.
cardiograph.
Yes.
So called ECG means electrocardiograph, which is used to measure the heartbeat. Now you know the ECG.
Yes.
Similarly, to measure the brain beat, we use EEG, electroencephalograph. Now are you clear?
Yes.
See that like this, if you understand anything, you can remember. It is quite natural that always brain will be jumping and connecting with one word to another word. Let me give one example, okay? Especially since you are a girl, I will take the example of girl only.
Okay.
You are from, I think you are a science student, is it?
Yes.
I have seen a lot of students. For example, let us see. One girl, she took the textbook of botany.
Okay.
She want to study. Generally what happened? She takes the book of botany and she started studying. When she takes the book, all she will be keep on reading for some time. Then she may go into dreams, is it not?
Yes,
generally, yeah.
It might happen.
She took the book of botany and she started thinking about botany. Wow, botany. When she's thinking about botany, she may be thinking about flowers.
Flowers,
right?
Yes.
Girls like flowers, is it
exactly.
not? See that when she's thinking about flowers, generally she may be thinking about the best flower in the world. Generally, most of the girls, which flower they like?
Rose.
Ah, rose. See that now she started thinking about roses. When she's thinking about roses, what comes into her mind? Roses means the good place in Karnataka is
Bangalore.
Ah, Bangalore. Now she's thinking about Bangalore roses. And when she's thinking about Bangalore, once again she may be thinking, Bangalore roses are good, but compared to Bangalore, one more place that is called Kashmir. Kashmir roses are so beautiful, right?
Yes.
Is it not? Girls like Kashmir. And see that when she's thinking about Kashmir, now her mind has gone to where her mind
Kashmir.
Has gone? Kashmir. Now she is thinking about Kashmir. When she is thinking about Kashmir, now she thinks about what's the big problem in Kashmir? Terrorist.
Terrorism.
Yeah. Now she started thinking about terrorist. When she is thinking about terrorist, she may be thinking, wow, Kashmir is beautiful, but only one problem is the terrorism. Now she thinks, okay, Kashmir people are good, only the terrorism is due to, she may be thinking, it may be real or
not,
we don't know. She may be thinking about Pakistan, because that Pakistan people only creating all the problems of terrorism in thing. Now tell me, where her mind has gone?
Pakistan.
Her mind has gone to Pakistan. Now she may be thinking about Pakistan. Oh, Pakistan people, all these people. Now she will be thinking, okay, Pakistan is a small country.
Mm.
They don't have that much power to face the India.
Exactly.
Why they are having so much power is some other country may be supporting.
Supporting.
Which country may be supporting?
Maybe it's America.
Ah, now see that.
She will think like
her thought process has jumped to America. Now she may be thinking about America. When she is thinking about America, generally what things come into her picture, her mind? It may be American people or American president, all these American pictures. Now she would be thinking, wow, America is such a beautiful country, such a wonderful country, so much freedom.
Yes.
Suppose if I had born in United States of America, I would have wear wonderful dresses. No restriction, dress code, nothing. Whatever you wear is a freedom country. Now she would be thinking like an American girl, which type of dresses they will be wearing, she will be thinking about America. Now tell me in examination, what she is going to write?
About American dresses.
Yeah. She, what textbook she has taken?
Botany.
Botany. Now from botany to where she has gone? First
American
is rose.
Yeah, rose.
First roses. Roses to Bangalore.
Bangalore.
Bangalore to?
Kashmir.
Kashmir. Kashmir to
terrorism.
Terrorism to?
Pakistan.
Pakistan. Pakistan to
America.
America to
their dresses.
Beautiful girls and their dresses.
Yes.
Now tell me what she can remember in the mind. All this chain, just by seeing one time, you are able to remember.
Yes.
Same thing. It is a pure trend of the mind. That's why some people said mind is like a monkey.
Mm-hmm.
It will be keep on jumping from one thing to one thing, one thing to one thing.
Right.
Can you stop thinking?
No, we can't stop thinking at all.
See that, but most of the adults will be saying to the students and all, hey, stop thinking, stop thinking, stop thinking. Can you stop thinking? No chance. Even adults also, most of the adults, always they will be in the dreams. Now, one thing it is clear that we can't stop thinking.
Yes.
So best is make the trend as a friend. Let me ask you one question. Tell me, swimming along the flow is easy or against the flow is easy?
Of course, along the flow.
Along the flow.
Yes.
Why? Because with less effort,
yes,
you can swim well, right?
Yeah.
Same thing, when it comes to studies, most of the people go against the flow of their mind. Here, we are taking trend as a best friend. So what we are doing is, whatever your brain likes, we started feeding, so that if you feed your brain the way it likes, definitely it is going to remember.
Okay.
Now what we have done is, in the linking exercise,
mm-hmm,
I started giving mountain to blackboard, birthday,
yes,
party. Mind was jumping from one thing to one thing, one thing to one thing, one thing to one thing.
Right.
Your mind was liking.
Yes.
That's why you are able to remember.
Okay.
Now, let us go into detail how you can do the linking. To do the linking, you have to follow certain steps.
Okay, Kailash, tell me one thing. How to do this linking?
Okay. You want to know?
Yes, of
really?
Course. Really? Really, I want to know.
Just you want to know or you want to do it?
I want to do it.
Yeah. To do the linking,
mm-hmm,
very interesting. Please pay attention here. Very simple. You have to follow some three-step formula, I can tell you. To do the linking, first is you have to sit in a power brain posture. I told you before starting,
yes,
is it not?
Exactly.
Because a posture is very much.
Kailash, I want to ask you something.
Yeah.
Why this posture is important? Because we do all the things with our mind.
Mm.
But why do you think this posture is important? What if I sit whatever the way I want?
Okay, good question. What you can do is, instead of explaining with the words, let us do one small exercise.
Mm-hmm.
So that you will come to know what is the importance of the posture.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, just now you said that what is the importance of the posture?
Yes.
Posture is very much important. The reason is, whenever you change the body posture, immediately it affects your psychology. That's why it is said, your physiology changes your psychology, and whatever your psychology shows on your physiology. When your psychology changes, definitely it affects on your physiology and it affects your body posture. Let us do one small exercise.
Yes, sure.
I will show that how the physiology changes your psychology, how the psychology is related with your physiology. What you have to do is, just you can open up chest like this.
Mm-hmm.
Look at the ceiling.
Okay.
Come on, you also start doing like this. Come on, look at the ceiling.
Mm-hmm.
Keep on smiling. Keep on smiling. Keep on smiling. Keep on smiling. Don't stop smiling. Keep on smiling. Feel smiling and feel sad. Keep on smiling and feel sad. Keep on smiling. Come on, keep on smiling and feel sad. Yeah, come back.
It's not possible to feel sad.
Why?
Because I'll be laughing and smiling, so how can I feel sad?
Have seen?
Yes.
Your body was in a happy mood. Smiling shows that happiness. When your physiology was in a happy mood, your mind cannot be in a sad mood.
Sad mood.
That's why it is said, your physiology changes your psychology. Same the way, when your psychology changes, it affects your physiology. That's why, have seen what is the importance of the posture. Let us do one more thing so that you will have more clarity. Shruta, are you clear? Now,
yes.
when you change the physiology, mm-hmm. psychology also changes.
But can you give me some more examples?
Okay, let us do one thing. I'm going to give an example. See that some of your relative or any friend or any one person has come to your house.
Yes.
Let us see that he is having a lot of problems. I have seen one of the person I met recently. That person, he is having cancer in his stomach. His mother, for almost 6 years, she is in bed because due to paralysis, she could not move here and there. She is in bed for almost 6 years. And you know, his father is a blind person. He can't walk, he can't do anything. Always somebody should be there. And unfortunate, his wife, she is having TB. And over that, recently what happened, police people caught his brother-in-law thinking that he is having connections with some terrorist group. That's why they caught him and they put him in the jail.
Very sad.
By listening that one, his sister committed suicide. See the family pathetic condition.
Yes.
Suppose I bring that person to your house, you make him to sit in your house.
Yes.
If he comes to your house, how he will be sitting? Can you show me?
He'll be sitting like this.
Yeah, he'll be sitting like this.
Yes.
Why he will not smile?
Because he's in depression.
Huh. See that means you know that when you are in a depression, you will be sitting like this. Same thing has just happened for you. Tell me some of your relatives, friends or somebody, if they are in depression, how they will be sitting?
They will be sitting.
Yes. That means it is clear that when your psychology changes, it affects your physiology.
Exactly.
When the person is in depression mood, they will be sitting like this. Like some people, especially girls, when they are in the sad, they will go and sleep on the bed. That too, have seen when they are sleeping, they will be sleeping like a three number. Yeah, with a depression mode. Mm-hmm. Let us do one small exercise, okay? Mm-hmm. Now, be ready.
Yes.
Imagine yourself, you are like a Maharani. Sit like a Maharaj, Maharani. Sit like Maharani. Wow, good. Really, you are looking like a Maharani.
Thank
Why you are smiling?
Because you told me to look, sit like a Maharani.
I told just like, sit like a Maharani. Why you are smiling? You can also try this, ma'am. You can try with your friends and family members. Tell them to sit like a Maharaja and Maharani. If he's a boy, tell him to sit like a Maharaja. If she's a girl, tell her to sit like a Maharani. See that naturally smile will come. Means when you change the physiology, your psychology also changes. Have seen the importance of the posture. Unfortunate, what most of the students do is when they go to exam, suppose if they are not getting the answer, what they'll do immediately? They'll be thinking. That means what physiology is saying? Depression.
Yes.
What psychology will be? They'll be more into depression. Have seen? So whenever you want to change the psychology, change the physiology. See that suppose if you are in a dull mood, see the body. Be aware how the body is in a position. If it is in a depressed position, immediately come back to the refreshing mood. For example, like whenever you are feeling happy, how the person when he is walking on the road, if the person is very happy, how he will be walking on the road? With shoulders open, with a smile, right? When the person is in a depression, how they will be walking?
He'll put his head down and he'll be walking. Like,
slowly.
Yeah.
Have seen?
Yes.
Happy people walking. It's not walking, we can't say as if they are running, right?
Exactly.
Have seen?
Yes.
Psychology affects your physiology. This is a psychological reason. Let me tell you one scientific reason. The reason is, suppose when you are sitting like this, this is called power brain posture. When you are sitting like this, your backbone is straight. And whatever the information you are feeding in your brain, it will pass on to your body so that you can remember very well. That's why in olden days you might have seen rishis and all, when they are doing meditation and tapas and all, they are sitting straight.
Yes.
You might have observed in your school and college, just they keep the desks also very straight.
Very straight.
They don't keep like a sofa or something. Of course, here we kept. They keep straight.
Yes.
Because to keep the backbone straight. Whenever you are studying, always see that your backbone is straight. Let me explain you scientific reason. When you are sitting like this, what will happen is your lungs get contrasted. Lungs are here, they will get contrasted. at the time, you will be taking less oxygen. When you are taking less oxygen, there will be less blood circulation in your body, and your brain also will be taking less oxygen. Let me tell you, my friends, the brain, it weighs only 2% of your body weight, but it consumes almost 35% of oxygen from your body. That means major portion will be taken by the brain. So it is our duty that we have to give more oxygen to the brain. When you are sitting like this, what will happen? You will be taking less oxygen. That leads to condition that brain will become dull. Sometimes it may go into auto shut off mode. So when you are sitting like this with an open hand, naturally you will be taking more oxygen. That's why you might have seen in olden days, the chairs were very broader, and for the kings, they were sitting like this.
Yes.
So what will happen? The chest will be open, the brain naturally will be active, they will be able to take the decisions correctly. When brain is dull, you can't take good decisions.
Exactly.
Have seen, anytime have you observed or you watched movies in small villages?
Yes.
Non-AC theatres,
yes.
And all? Suppose heavy crowd is there, it is a summertime, after watching the afternoon show, when you are coming back from the movie hall, how you will be feeling? You will be feeling fresh?
Very exhausted.
Yes.
Why? Because the theater will be like that, and breathless feel, and no comfortable things.
Because they close all the doors?
Yes.
All the windows?
No.
If it is not a non-AC hall?
Yes.
All the carbon dioxide will be circulating, so you will feel exhausted. Now tell me, suppose you are gone for picnic. When you are getting down from the bus, how you will be getting down? Can you show me?
Like very happily, free.
Have seen?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because you get down like wow.
Wow. Yes. Naturally it comes.
Yeah.
Because when you are getting down from bus, you will be saying like this.
Yes.
Wow.
Wow.
That means your chest gets expanded. It naturally, without your awareness, you will be taking more oxygen.
Have
seen?
Fresh.
This is the importance of the posture. Have you got it?
Yes.
Not only for this exercise, whenever you are studying, always sit straight so that you will not be creating any stress in your part. First is posture.
Posture.
And to do the linking, second thing is visualization. Visualization means everything. In the beginning I told to see everything in pictures, right?
Okay.
The reason is, any information, if it is in form of pictures, your brain can understand better. It can see. If it is only in the sound, brain may forget. That's why I